Hi friends, I am Sunil Gupta. Welcome here at the platform of Edugami. In the lecture series of our topic-wise discussion on public administration, I am going to continue the lecture. So in the previous lecture, I have made the discussion about the classical theory. What is the classical theory? Where is the focal area of the classical theory? And now I am going to discuss the criticism of classical theory of organization. So you knew very well, a scientific management theory came into being, but it got limited theory because of the size. It was concentrated only upon the shop floor level. Later on, bureaucratic theory came into being. Then and thereafter, they concentrated upon the big government with the rules and regulations, systematization of human being under hierarchical setup. But one step above of the rules and regulations, this is called the principle of organization. And principle-based organization, what is called the classical organization, and the theory constructed based upon this is called the classical theory of organization. So you know very well that classical theory has to focus upon, that is, the principle regulates public administration. So there is fixed principle of the public administration, and principles are objective in nature, principles are universal in nature, and principle can be, you know, maybe a part of the prediction, means predictability, objectivity, and universality will have to come under the classical theory of organization. And so Gulick and Urwitt in 1937, when published the papers on science of public administration, declared that public administration is a part of science. But it got challenged by different scholars on different background, right? So let's automatically see what are the grounds for the challenges, or you can say the criticism of the classical theory. So these are the backgrounds that is before you in the PPT. So let us automatically begin the study upon this one. The first ground was, it is the impracticality of science character of public administration. This is being challenged by two important persons. One is called the Dehal, and another important person is called the Waldo. The Waldo and Dehal has made the criticism against classical theory of organization. Okay, this is the science character. Science is not going to exist. Dehal, in his book, Science of Public Administration, Three Problems, published in 1947, declared that public administration can never be objectivity because there is existence of normative value. Prediction is not possible because human behavior cannot be predicted. And universality, iska to sawal hi nahi hota, because every nation has the national psychology to deal with. So based upon this, you can say impracticality of science character of public administration came into play, right? Simon has made the, you know, criticism on the basis of myth. Myth is concerned. Myth ka matlab ye ho jata hai ki that is, it seems as to be, but it's a hota nahi hai, mythly proverbs. So in his administrative behavior has made the criticism and has to say that many inconsistent principles are going to exist at the same place. Once upon a time has to say unity of commands should be there, and another important has to say here, that is, ki there should be functional specialization. The topmost level pe functional specialization and unity of command cannot work. Similarly, it has to say less span of control and the less hierarchy level, how can it be possible? So based upon that, they have made the criticism. Machine modeling theory. So Simon and Marsh had made the criticism based upon that. It is like the scientific management theory is going to understand human as a part of the machine, and so called the machine model theory. Many person has to say oversimplification of motivation. Mayo also criticized that this is the oversimplified the motivation. Only a set of, you know, a few set of the incentives are regarded as the part of motivation. But it is not going to happen. Dignity is going to happen. Responsibility is going to happen. Achievement is there. So based upon that, you know, it has to say no. Many person like the Bernard has to make the criticism. This is the anti-behavioral theory. It is not going to understand, you know, initiatives may be taken by human being. Sense of responsibilities are going to happen with the human being. So this is, one has to say this is a neglect of the complex, you know, information processing. Who told? It is Simon and Marsh. So these two person, you know, got published kiya organization, so journal was there. And isi mein unhone kaha ki nahi, jo information processing system, a communication system, and that is based upon the formal and informal communication system. Shayad inhone informal communication system ko samjha hi nahi. Jab tak informal communication system ko tum nahi samajhte, you cannot make the prediction and you cannot make the conclusion upon the decision. Neglect of inter-organizational conflict, organizational, OR. Organizational का मतलब है कि अंदर से जो भी inter-organizational conflict based upon the value system, ये तो इन्होंने expect ही नहीं किया, तो based upon that, this is automatically neglect. Baron Banis का एक बहुत important statement है, organization without people, that is called the classical organization. अगर आप organization मशीन को मार रहे हैं तब तो ठीक है, अगर आप मशीन को नहीं मान करके अगर आप कहते हैं कि ये ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ह्यूमन के साथ है तो क्लासिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नहीं हो सकता. क्लासिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में सब आदमी मशीन है, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विदाउट पीपल तो सब कुछ काम करेगा, प्रिंसिपल विल बी वर्केबल. तो वेरी ग्रेट कमेंट हियर. लैक ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच, तो सुब्रमण्यम, वी सुब्रमण्यम हमारे इंडियन स्कॉलर हैं, उनका ये मानना है दिस इज द प्रो मैनेजरियल अप्रोच एंड इट मे क्रिएट एलिटिस्टिक कल्चर लेटर ऑन. इसलिए इन्होंने कहा कि लैक ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड अप्रोच हियर एंड डीलिंग ऑफ इनफॉर्मल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. इनफॉर्मल एंड फॉर्मल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड बी लिंक्ड, बट इन्होंने डीलिंग कर दिया एंड बेस्ड अपॉन दैट द डिसीजन हैज टू कम ऑन दिस ग्राउंड मेनी पर्संस वी हैव गॉन थ्रू, राइट. तो क्वेश्चन जब भी आता हो तो अगर आप क्वेश्चन का आंसर लिखते हैं यू हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ तीन इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट. फर्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्ट इज देयर कि इसका ग्राउंड देना जरूरी है कि कौन सा ग्राउंड. सेकेंड, उस स्कॉलर का नाम देना जरूरी है जिन्होंने क्रिटिसिज्म किया. और थर्ड, अगर क्रिटिसिज्म करते समय किसी टर्मिनोलॉजी को यूज किया है स्कॉलिस्टिक टर्म्स, उसको भी देना इसमें जरूरी है. जैसे मिथ एंड होमली प्रोवर्ब्स किसने बोला, ये टर्म्स है जो साइमन ने दिया. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विदाउट पीपल, ये टर्म्स है जो वारेन बेनिस ने दिया, राइट. तो ये चीज को लिखना वहां पे जरूरी है, राइट. तो चलो आज हमने क्रिटिसिज्म के बारे में डिस्कस किया. तो क्या क्लासिकल थ्योरी बिल्कुल फ्लॉप थ्योरी है? ऐसा नहीं है. क्लासिकल थ्योरी भी एक रिलेवेंट थ्योरी है. तो रिलेवेंट कैसे है, कैसे बना वो रिलेवेंट थ्योरी, वी विल हैव टू मेक द डिस्कशन इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो, राइट. तो अगले वीडियो में बच्चे हम लोग इसको डिस्कस करते रहेंगे. तो चलो कंटिन्यू करते हैं इस सीरीज को. इस सीरीज को तुम लोग देखते रहना एंड इफ यू फील कि कुछ और भी चीज हमें चाहिए देन यू हैव टू जस्ट नोट इट. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस.